When I work, I often need to go back to a document or a website that I visited earlier. But sometimes, no matter how hard I search for it, I just can't find it. Sound familiar? This is where Microsoft claims Windows Recall can help. It captures everything you do on your computer. Every document, email, website, photo, everything. Then it organizes all of it into a searchable timeline. What's amazing is you can search using just everyday words. Here's an example. If I type in chocolate chip cookie website, it finds that I visited a website called thekevincookiecompany.com. Or I can quickly locate a photo of an airship. And there it is. Think of it as your perfect second brain. It stores and recalls information whenever you need it. But of course, there's a catch. When Windows Recall was first announced, it faced backlash for privacy concerns. After all, it's taking a snapshot of everything you do on your computer. How comfortable are you with that? In this video, I'll show you how you can get started with Windows Recall. We'll look at how it works, and also we'll touch on whether you should worry about privacy and security. Let's dive in. Let's start by looking at how you can even get Windows Recall. Right now, it's only available to Windows insiders on the dev channel. Now, that sounds complicated. Can you get it? Yes. Anyone can join the Windows Insider program. Simply head to this website, register, and you'll get early access to all these new exciting features like Recall. Once you're signed up, here's how to enable it on your PC. Press Windows together with I to open settings. Then click on Windows Update and navigate to Windows Insider Program. From here, you can opt into the dev channel, and this is where Recall is currently being tested. As testing progresses, Microsoft plans to roll this out to all Windows users. So if you're eager to try it out now, the Insider Program is your way to get it. Once you finish opting into the Windows Insider Program and to the dev channel, down below on your taskbar, go down to the search field and let's launch Recall. Right down here, type in Recall and you should see it as the best match. Let's click on this option. And here, you'll get the Windows security notification. That's because Windows Recall is only available to you. Only you have access. Right over here, I'll click on OK. If this is your first time accessing Recall, you'll have to opt in. It's not turned on by default. Right over here, let's now minimize this window. And down on the taskbar, you'll see the Windows Recall icon. This lets you know that Windows Recall is currently running. Right here, let's click on the icon, and this opens up a quick preview window. Right up on top, we can see the last snapshot that it took. Right down here, you could also open up the full Recall experience. And in a little bit, we'll do this. And right down below, you can also pause any snapshots. Down at the bottom, we also have some additional settings. And in a bit, we'll come back to that. But once you have Recall running, you can now go about and do what you would normally do on your computer. If you need any ideas, I highly recommend checking out thekevincookiecompany.com. I hear they have the best cookies in the world, so feel free to check out this website. Now, one thing to call out with browsers, it'll take snapshots when you're browsing the web. However, if you're using in-private browsing or incognito, it will not take snapshots of that. Right up on top, I'll now minimize this window. Once you're ready to get back to some information or content or recall information, sorry, I had to throw that in at least one time in this video. You can click on the icon on your taskbar, and right here we can open Recall, or you can also press a shortcut key. Sometimes it feels like just about everything in Windows has a shortcut key associated with it. Press the Windows key together with J, and that also opens up Recall. And here we see that Windows security notification again. Right down below, let's click on OK. This now drops us into the main Recall experience. And right up on top, we see a timeline that you can use to navigate through your entire day, and you can see everything that you've done. Now, right up on top, this is where the true power of Recall comes in. Right up here, we have a search field where you can search for different items. Now, I know that at some point today, I watched a YouTube video on new features in Windows, but I'm not quite sure what that video was called or who the creator was. So let's just try searching for it to see if maybe Recall can help. Right up here, I'll type in YouTube video about 5 Windows features, and then let's search. And right here, I see all the different matches, and it looks like there's a text match right here. I'll click on this, And here it has a snapshot of YouTube with this video called 5 Hidden Windows Features. How did I forget this one? It's my own video. One of the cool things when we look at the video, it understands and recognizes all the different text on the screen. So you can search against this. Down at the very bottom, I can also take action on this. Let's say I want to go back to this YouTube video. I can click on this and this opens up YouTube and brings me to that exact video. It's such a cool way of getting back. I have a few other actions, and over here, I can click on this, and I can also delete this snapshot. Let's say it's not something that I want to keep in my timeline. Here, I can remove everything from a specific application, a specific website, or just this individual snapshot. And over here, I have some additional actions. Let's now try another one. I remember that we had some customer feedback complaining that our vegan cookies were dry. Now, I can't imagine why anyone would ever have anything negative to say about the Kevin Cookie Company, but let me see if I could get back to that. Now, I don't know if it was in a document or on a website, so right up on top, I'll simply type in vegan cookies were dry, and let's try searching for that. Right down below, I can see that there's a text match in a Word document. And when I click on this, this jumps to that item on my timeline. It looks like I worked on this earlier, and it was actually some feedback about the vegan chocolate chip cookies, and it looks like they were a bit dry. We'll have to take action against that. Right up on top, let's try another one. Right here, I'll type in airship. I remember we had, oh, there it is. We had a graphic that shows what a blimp would look like for the Kevin Cookie Company. And here too, it recognizes text on the image. Now what's cool is this is just an image file, but I was able to search for a word and it automatically understands that this is an airship. This is honestly really cool for getting back to things that you've worked on. In the top right-hand corner, let's now look at some of the settings. I'll click on the three dots here and let's go down to settings. Here in settings at the very top, you can turn recall on or off. Right here, you can also decide how much space you want to allocate to recall. The more space that you allocate, the longer your timeline will be, the less, the shorter your timeline will be. Taking screenshots or snapshots continuously eats up quite a bit of space, so keep that in mind. Down below, you can also apply various filters. Right here, you can filter sensitive information. Let's say you're typing in a password or a credit card number. You probably don't want that to be part of your snapshots. Over here, you can have it automatically remove that. You can also filter out certain apps or certain websites, and then you have a few other settings down below. I personally think recall is a game changer for finding information. As long as you can remember a clue, like let's say a word in a document or the topic of a YouTube video that you watched, you'll be able to get back to it. It really is like having your own second brain. Now, about privacy and security. According to Microsoft, all snapshots are encrypted. Only you have access and they're not using it for training. And it's all completely opt-in. If you're curious about the details though, I've included a link in the description. You can take a look at that and why don't you decide for yourself. When this feature first launched, there were big security gaps. I really do appreciate though that Microsoft listened to all of that feedback and then they went back and they revamped the feature before rolling it out again. So what do you think? Is this a feature that you see yourself using? I see that it gives me a lot of value and I would use it. Please consider subscribing and I'll see you in the next video.